Garoppolo gets the snap, drops back. Good protection over the middle. Hits Lora at the 20. Cuts it up to the 15, to the 10, to the 9. Lora, first and goal, Eastern Illinois. Third and three. Large rolling out to the right. Gets outside the contain. He's going to dump it off over the middle. Hits Lora. He's at the 10. He's still going to the 7. Fights forward to the 5. It'll be first down and goal to go on the pass to Lora. Here's Large back to throw it on second down. Steps up, rifles the end zone, touchdown! Lora caught it in the back of the end zone. Garoppolo is going to take a handoff, rolling out to the right, throwing into the end zone, touchdown! Erik Lora! Rolling right, pressure to dodge the rush. Still looking upfield, now throwing deep downfield. Lora with a great catch at the 20-yard line. Lora with a leaping catch and a big gain deep into Murray territory.
In 2010, as a sophomore, Erik Lora was among the top wide receivers in the Ohio Valley Conference. He suffered an injury in the spring of 2011, which forced him to miss the 2011 season as the Panthers struggled to a finish of 2-9. This season, Lora has returned and is happy to be back.
It was a struggle for me last year, watching the team and them not having so much success and me not being able to help because I had that injury. But, it worked out for the best. We got new coaches. You know, we're on a pretty good streak right now. You know, we had a tough loss against a good Western team. But, we're moving forward and we're looking forward to ISU.
Second down, 10 to go. Here's Garoppolo, two-step drop, flips it over the middle, hits Lora at the 5, breaks a tackle, he's in. Touchdown, Eastern Illinois. Lora made the catch, cutting over the middle at the 5, and then made a nice run to skip out of a tackle.
Since he was not a part of the offense last season, his season-opening performance against Southern Illinois may have caught some people by surprise, but Lora knew where he was as a player.
I mean, I led the team in receptions my sophomore year, but Chris led them in touchdowns and yards. But me and Chris, we share the ball a lot. We do as much as we can for the offense. It feels good to be back, helping the team win some games.
With 13 catches for 151 yards in the opener against SIU, this new up-tempo Baylor-style offense, with an emphasis on getting the ball to the wide receivers, is something Lora and his teammates are happy to be playing in.
This offense is one of, a better offense that would fit my type of receiving ability. I catch the ball, get upfield, try to get as many yards after the catch. But, we pride ourselves on catching the ball, getting forward, getting yards, getting first downs, keeping the tempo up.
Lora also knew that with a new offensive scheme, opportunities for catches would be aplenty under a new head coach like Dino Babers.
I had seen some Baylor tape. It was actually fun because Baylor throws the ball a lot. And then when coach came over and he said he was going to use that offense, it put a little bit of pressure on the receivers because we weren't so much of a passing team. But, it's worked out for the best. Chris, me, Shavar, Sam, Vaughn, all the other receivers, Drake, we've all worked pretty hard on working on our receiving skills. Coach Babers is a good coach and knows his stuff about the receiving corps.
While Lora may be the Panthers' top wide receiver in terms of catches, he admits that teammate Chris Wright have a personal competition on which receiver can haul in the most touchdowns this season.
We had a deal after the first game that whoever scores the more touchdowns, the other person has to buy them dinner at the end of the season. So, it's all fun and games, but of course I wish Chris to score every time he touches the ball, and he does the same for me. We, all the receivers and the running backs and all the skill positions on offense, we just want to put points on the board and, just help the team win some games.
Lora's 13 catches for 151 yards may have shocked some people, but it definitely opened the eyes of opposing coaches like those at Western Michigan, who despite matching up with Lora, still allowed the junior to catch 5 passes for more than 100 yards.
They were running some different defenses in the second half and middle of the second quarter. They manned me up pretty much the whole game. We just weren't successful on the offensive and defensive side of the ball. But, we've put some measures in to not let that happen at ISU. And we're going to, do some damage on offense.
One of the advantages of sitting out last season for Lora was to be able to watch the maturation process of Jimmy Garoppolo. Lora was a veteran receiver when Garoppolo was cutting his teeth as a true freshman starter. Now 2 years later, Lora has seen Garoppolo develop by leaps and bounds.
Jimmy's smart. He does his homework. He knows defenses. He reads them perfectly. Coach Babers and Coach Gilbert does a great job teaching Jimmy. Jimmy absorbs that. He's a sponge. He learns on the fly. He's real good about that. And he has an arm. He puts the ball where he wants to, and he's been really successful at that lately. And it's fun seeing Jimmy grow, struggling as a freshman or starting freshman, coming in here last year, putting up some numbers, but not being able to win some games. And then finally, Jimmy Garoppolo, we all know now, can throw the ball, read defenses, and win some games.
In addition to his numbers as a wide receiver his sophomore year, Lora was also called on to run several fly sweeps, as he was among the Panthers' top ground gainers. This new offense may allow him to run, but he decides that heavy work is best left up to the running backs.
That hurt him. They hand off to Lora on first down, sweeping the left end, cuts back across the 50, hurdles a man to the 45, got to the 42. Another wide receiver run by Eastern, and this time Erik Lora made a very nice run.
We try to give the ball to the running backs. A running game is a crucial part of an offensive strategy. But, we have some plays for me to run the ball. I'm more of a receiver. I can run the ball, but yards after catch is what I like to focus on.
One of the gimmick-type plays the offense has allowed Lora to already show this season is the ability to throw a wide receiver pass. Both Lora and teammate Sam Hendricks had touchdown passes in the opener against SIU.
First down, 10 to go. Garoppolo, quick pass out to the right side, caught by Lora. He wants to throw a pass into the end zone. Touchdown! Chris Wright brought it in from Lora. And for the second time tonight, an EIU receiver has thrown a touchdown pass.
Honestly, I was pretty in shock, almost like Chris on his catch this weekend. The linebacker came up in my face. I had to take a sidestep and just kind of put it out there. Chris, had another one-handed catch. It was just an amazing feeling to know that, I can pass the ball. And we have the ability to run plays like that and be successful at it.
As one of the nation's leading receivers this season, Lora will continue to move up the EIU record book. At Western Michigan, he moved over the 1,000-yard mark for receiving in his career, while the 13 catches against SIU rank in the top five for a single game at EIU.
I just kind of focus on winning the game, and if records come along with it, it helps. It's fun.
Despite any accolades that may come due to his ability on the field, the final goal for Lora and the Panthers is to win games and championships, something that has been the motto at EIU for a number of years.
Well, we plan on winning the OVC this year. We pride ourselves. We come to work every day, plan on winning games. And, the confidence level on this team is high because we set a bar for success. And, I'm excited for this season. We've been working hard. And the OVC is a tough conference, and we have a couple guys who are ranked top 25 in the nation. So it's going to be some work in front of us, but we plan on winning the OVC this year.
So after suffering an injury that set him back 1 year, Lora is happy to be back as he helped the team some as a scout team player last season, now to a full-time starter this season.
Surgery is always a bad thing. It's not good. It put me out for a couple months. I had to get back in shape and football shape. But when I got back last year, I was helping with scout on the team and helping the defense get better and being a key receiver for any other teams. But it just feels good to be back playing football, making receptions, touchdowns, and just, it feels good.